Feydolls, welcome back to my channel, and I'm here with a foundation routine. This video is literally going to show you how I do my foundation, my highlight, my contour, and it's literally going to give you a few tips, a few tricks, and a few freaks. You know, you just have to find something to rhyme. So if you want to see how I achieve this look and how I do my foundation routine, then keep on watching. Okay, so firstly I'm going to start off with my primer. Just start with priming my face, literally just to keep the makeup on. And I'm using this Urban Decay Primer. It makes your foundation stay on all day, it's amazing, and it gives you like a flawless finish. It's the shiz. Tap it on forehead, face. Not too much. It's all around my face, literally. And what I tend to do is make sure that my face is already kind of moisturized, like the cream that I use after I've like come out of the shower, just so that I can just have a bit more moisture to my face and just kind of glow when I put my foundation on. Then I'm gonna use my MAC concealer palette. This palette is the bomb. It's a bit pricey. It has a corrector in it, red corrector, so that just literally just cancels out dark areas. And as you can see, I have like dark areas around my mouth, under my eyes, so I'm just gonna cancel that out. Just gonna place a little bit on my finger, just literally dry it around my mouth, not too much. Don't want to look like a bloody Satsuma. Place some underneath my eyes as well. So once you're looking like an orange, now you can move on to your foundation, but not just yet. What I do is I like to smother my face in this NYX liquid illuminator. What it does, it just gives you like a bronze look. It makes you glow once you put your foundation on, and it's amazing. It's so nice. So I'm just gonna put just a little bit on my face. Literally just rub it or just dab it on my face. I like to put loads on. I like using my hands for most of my products because it tends to just like warm up the product, so the product can just go nicely on your skin. I am using the Fenty Beauty, the one and only by Rihanna. This is the bomb, literally. I'm not even exaggerating because it's Rihanna. It's actually really nice. Like once I put it on, what I do is I mix it with my NYX. This is in the color medium beige, and this is also a bomb as well. The bomb.com, these two are my go-to's everyday foundation, and it just does the job for me. So now what I'm gonna do is just literally dab it on my skin. Look at that color already, it's popping. Just dab it all around. Then I get my beauty blender, the Real Technique. Yeah, this is by Real Techniques. It's amazing as well. It's literally the same as actual original beauty blender. It's amazing, soft, love it. So what I do is just blend that in. And what I do tend to do is like put it over, put the foundation over my eyelids, just so that it can, I can use it as a base for when I put on my eyeshadow. So once that's all blended in, what I like to do is use my Real Techniques brush. It's a kabuki brush, and literally just push that into the skin. And down my neck. Now I'm gonna go back into my MAC palette, my go-to, and go into this color over here. It's a bit messy, I know, so I use it all the time. Go into this is the lighter shade, and I'm just literally gonna put it underneath my eyes. And this is the start of the highlight. Cover them eye bags, because we do not do eye bags. Even though our eye bags are Chanel, but we don't do that. But yeah. So now I'm going to use my Pure Beige concealer. This is a pro concealer. It's affordable, amazing, does the job. I'm just gonna do a couple lines, let's say. And I kind of like bring it down here, so when I do blend it in, kind of gives me that triangle effect, and it kind of makes my face look slimmer once I put the contour. Just gonna highlight my nose. So once you're looking all crazy like this, and then you begin to blend and blend and blend. So here we go, and I use the clean side and just literally blend. Just bring it into my nose, and I try and use the beauty blender very gently because we don't want all the products to come off. I'm gonna squeeze the beauty blender and literally just blend my highlight. I'm looking creamy. Guys, the aim is to look creamy. I wanna look like creamy. I don't know if you understand what I mean, but there's this creamy effect that your skin literally looks like butter, and that is my aim. That is my aim, like, I wanna look like butter. Oh god. I'm gonna use my black opal stick, and what I'm gonna do is just carve out my contour. And I'm gonna contour my nose. And make sure you just do that little triangle bit of my nose. Don't know why, when I do that, when I put my highlight on, it literally just gives me like a button nose. Which I love. Now I'm gonna use my beauty blender again. I'm gonna use this side this time and literally just push upwards while I'm blending. I'm gonna try and blend it in the same place, just so that it doesn't, you know, move from its position. Because we don't want contour down there, do we? We want it just on the cheekbone. I'm gonna try and literally, this is where the like control of your hand comes in. And you just. Now I'm gonna use the bottom of the peat blender to just squeeze it like this, and literally just blend out my nose contour. And I'm just gonna bring it into my crease, into my eyeshadow crease, so that it makes that kind of contour effect. You can see it. Can you see that contour? Can you see that already? Oh my god, we be popping. I'm popping. So I get another concealer. I told you guys we build with the concealer because we want to be looking freaky. This is okay, so if I was like going on a normal day out, this will be where I stop. But if I'm going on a night out, I'll add a lighter concealer just underneath my eyes, so that it can pop literally. Then I just place it underneath just a little bit, because this is a really light, as you can see. It's three strokes. Go back in with the beauty blender and literally just blend in that area. Again, keep on control of your beauty blender. We don't want it to be going anywhere else. Come on and give me that green light. Come on and give me. Come on and give me that green. So I'm gonna go into my MAC Prep and Prime. This is my go-to as well. It's literally just a white powder that I used to set my whole face. So what I do is go with a powder brush and literally just get that, place it underneath my eye. As I've blended my last highlight, which go into it and just go around my whole face, just lightly, not too much, just very lightly. And then I use this sheer loose powder by Collection. It's so cheap, it's from Superdrug, it's £5. Just bring it into my nose. I think I've put a bit too much. There we go. Yeah, I've just put too much now. I don't like putting too much. Bring it into my nose just to create that nose contour once again. Now I'm looking all powdery. What I'm gonna do is use this powder brush just to blend out that excess powder that I've put under my contour, because I don't want it to be too harsh, and if you leave it on for too long it will become ashy. So I just literally dust that off, and my chin as well. But what I do is leave my under eye to bake. And what I'm going to do is my eyebrows, but I'm going to do that off camera. Okay, so what I'm going to do is literally just dust this off with my powder brush. Dust away. So what I'm going to do is go into my MAC Mineralizing Powder in Dark Deepest and literally just bronze up my face. Literally just go around and bronze up my face. My forehead, a bit on my nose. Then I'm going to contour and go into my Morphe palette. It's a bit dirty, sorry. I'm literally going to use this colour here to contour. As you can see, I'll go with the same brush. Literally just, as you can see, I'm going to just swipe it and blow it off, because it is quite pigmented and I don't want it to be too difficult to blend out. And I like to use this brush because it's not too defined, so it would not give me any like harsh lines, and it will just kind of look like a natural contour, if you understand what I'm trying to say. Now I'm going to go into my dark mineralized powder, and this is actually the same colour as me. So this is the finishing powder that I use just to blend everything in, so everything looks seamless and one. Okay, as you can see, I've done my eyeshadow off camera and applied my eyelashes. I'm using the Revolution highlighter. What it's done is it's literally broken, literally just now. And it's just hard work, but so I literally can't really show you, but it's really nice. I'm gonna use my fan brush and literally my fan brush. Just gonna use my fan brush, get it together, and literally just apply it. Just want to be glowing, you know. That's what you gotta do. You gotta glow. And I'll literally just put it. My little button nose. Create a little button nose. Button nose. Button nose. Yes, I've got so much here. It's just so cute. Put a little bit here. Just to give that illusion. That I have no bridge, even though I have no bridge. The thing is, it's not glittery, but it's like a metallic glow, and it's literally everything. Look at that. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. No. The princess is here. Sierra. This beat is automatic, supersonic, hypnotic, funky, fresh. With my body. Now I'm gonna do my lips. Just gonna do a nude color. This is the NYX lip liner in the colour, what colour is this? Chestnut, and it's my go-to. That's what I use. Just gonna literally line my lips with this. I like to create like a V shape. Literally gonna go into my NYX in London. This is my go-to. If you know me, you know this is my go-to for my everyday look, even when I'm just going out. A night out, this is my go-to. I love it. Blend that in. Now I'm gonna use my NYX finish matte spray. I'm kind of obsessed with NYX, so I'm just gonna use that and literally just spray my face. Ooh, you know what I'm talking about, babe. Time for you to show me what it's hitting for. Sip
a little check, maybe blow a little dro. Love you from behind.